Royal Wedding Countdown. Meghan Markle preparing for her big day with the help of designer and aide. Meghan Markle and Prince Harry will officially be tying the knot at St. George's Chapel Inn, and each and every week, ET will be breaking down all the latest updates as they gear up for their May 19th nuptials. Biggest news of the week. While there was plenty of royal news that flooded our inboxes this week, we were most excited about getting an update on Meghan's wedding dress. We already knew that she had selected a dress designer, thanks to her stylist-turned-pal, Jessica Moroney, but now we know what she'll be wearing on her special day is officially in the design process. A source told ET earlier this week that Meghan has already met with the dress designer, and is busy adding unique touches to the couple's big day. We also found out that the Los Angeles native has been appointed a secretary to handle her increasingly busy royal schedule and duties. Amy Picario, a former Kensington Palace press officer, was announced on Monday as the new assistant private secretary in the office of Prince Harry. As for Meghan and Prince Harry's actual wedding day, expect a lot of security. Ken Wharf, the late Princess Diana's former bodyguard, told ET on Thursday that police will make sure nothing is overlooked for the massive occasion, and no expense will be spared. From my own experiences, and speaking to colleagues within the last few weeks, Scotland Yard and neighboring police forces that will be part of this operation will be only too aware of how important it is to make sure that no stone is left unturned, and you know, one talks in this day of austerity of finance, he said. Trust me on this occasion, finance has nothing to do with this. Scotland Yard, together with Thames Valley Police, which will be policing this event, money is not an object, and they make sure that the very best of security is put on display to make sure that security is not compromised. And after the soon-to-be married couple's anthrax scare last Monday, we wouldn't be surprised if there's even more heightened security as they continue their royal duties ahead of their nuptials. Royal Rumor Roundup. Looks like Meghan and Kate Middleton have been spending even more quality time together. The former Suits star often goes from her Nottingham cottage to Kate's humble abode to have tea or exchange advice, according to US Weekly. Meghan shares tips she's read about healthy eating, a source told the publication. And while it's not a rumor, it seems as if people are comparing Meghan to Princess Diana more and more frequently. According to multiple reports, the bride-to-be has been making secret visits to comfort victims of the Grenfell Tower, much like when Diana would also sneak away from Kensington Palace to visit hospital patients. Meghan's visits mean so much to us. She has a special place in our hearts, one community member, who met the soon-to-be royal, told D. Out and About. After making a trip to Scotland, Meghan and Harry took a break from the spotlight this week, but did have time for a fun date night. The engaged couple attended a Hamilton show at the Victoria Palace Theatre in London's West End last Friday night. One of the show's cast members, Leslie Garcia Bowman, even took to Twitter to express his excitement over having the couple in attendance. Serving up Suits. If you've been following along with our Royals Countdown each week, then you're well aware that we've been binge-watching Meghan's show, Suits, since the beginning. This week, we were super happy to see Meghan, who plays aspiring lawyer Rachel Zane, try on an Anne Barge wedding gown during the Cold Feet episode of Season 5. When the episode originally aired on the USA Network last year, Meghan spoke with Glamour, revealing some of her personal favorite bridal styles. Delphine Manivet and Christos Castellanos are faves of mine for their uniqueness and beauty, she gushed at the time. I will always be a fan of Ellie Saab. J. Mendel is spectacular as well, especially for more structural designs. Watch Meghan model her character's wedding dress in the video below, sparkle like Markle. Because our muscles are still kinda hating us from trying Meghan's favorite Pilates class last week, more on that here, we decided to take it easy this time by having a treat yourself night. We sat back, relaxed and drank like Meghan. Yes, turns out, girl loves a good wine. God, do I love wine. A beautiful full red or a crisp white, she revealed in an interview with The New Potato in 2013. But if it's cocktails, I love a spicy tequila cocktail, Negroni, or a good scotch, neat. Rather regal looks. The queen-to-be truly shined. The 7-month pregnant Duchess of Cambridge looked exquisite at the 2018 BAFTAs, Britain's equivalent to the Oscars, On February 18, the expecting mother donned a dark green Jenny Packham gown with cap sleeves and a black ribbon to accentuate her baby bump. Kate accessorized her regal look with emerald and diamond earrings and a matching necklace. Next in line, on to Prince William and, of course, more Kate. The Duchess began her week alongside Sophie, Countess of Wessex, by hosting the Commonwealth Fashion Exchange reception at Buckingham Palace. The brunette beauty arrived wearing a black and white floral printed and lace dress with black heels, and talked to designers and artisans from around the Commonwealth about their work. Meanwhile, the Duke of Cambridge proved he's the coolest dad around town, taking a spin on a motorcycle during his trip to Triumph Motorcycles and Mira Technology Park in Warwickshire on February 20. Rocking a sleek black motorcycle jacket, he took a test drive on a red Triumph Tiger 1200. Both William and Kate continued their royal duties the following day by paying a visit to the Fire Station Sun, one of Sunderland, England's most iconic buildings. There, they put on hard hats and reflective vests as they ventured to the Northern Spire, a new bridge over the River Wear that is scheduled to open later this year. Queen Elizabeth II also had quite the interesting week. Her Majesty graced fashionistas with her presence at London Fashion Week, where she presented the inaugural Queen Elizabeth II Award for British Design to Richard Quinn. The 91-year-old head of the monarchy looked enthusiastic as she sat front row next to Vogue editor-in-chief Anna Wintour at the Emerging British Designers Runway Show. Queen Elizabeth was sophisticatedly dressed in a powder blue Angela Kelly skirt and matching jacket with black gloves and a chic handbag. Lastly, what we've all been waiting for will finally happen. The Fab Four, Kate, William, Meghan and Harry, will all attend the first annual Royal Foundation Forum on Wednesday. And you can bet we'll be going all out for the royal couple's first engagement together since Christmas. And that's a wrap on your weekly Royals update. Join us next week for another roundup, and stay tuned to EatOnline.com daily for the latest on the royal family.